Hey everybody, it's me, Liz, coming to you live from my kitchen. It's Sunday. Hello. It's so quiet on the interwebs today because everybody's watching the Olympics. I am not watching the Olympics. I don't watch a lot of television. There's only one television in this house. I didn't have a television where I lived before. I watch everything that I want to watch on TV on my computer. There are numerous places to watch it. So if I had a room where I always hung out and there's a TV on in the background, I'd probably watch the Olympics, but I have to go out of my way and I'm not going to do it. Please enjoy. I hope all your teams and all your favorite people win. But in the meantime, I'm having Chinese food today. I got some rather good news recently on the work-at-home job front. As you know, I'm home taking care of elderly mom, and I, by trade, am a German translator. And the German translating business has gone down tremendously over the years because of the economy. And I still do some, and I do this, that, and the other few things online, editing and writing and things. But I just came into a wonderful opportunity through a friend who owns a business to do some other stuff. I'm not going into the details because, you know, I'm not telling everything. But it's tremendous news. It's amazing news, and it's amazing work, and they're amazing people. And it can be done from home, so I can get everything done. I can make the cooking videos. I can take care of mom and do what she needs doing, and I can work and make money. Woohoo! Yay me. And so we're having a little celebration around the old Snarzle home today, and I am springing for some Chinese food. I mean, the whole works, for a couple of other friends of mine who have done so much for me over the last few stressful months, my friends Alan and Amanda. Alan is the one who called my food effed up. Do you remember? He said effed up. He said her effed up cooking videos. So, if the guy who said that I make effed up cooking videos is coming to have Chinese food with me today, what is he getting for dessert? Circus peanut sushi? Of course he is. Oh, look at that. I opened up, you can't see, I opened up the butter dish and there was nothing in it. But I have another one right here and it has something in it. I've decided that I am going to use for my sushi wrappers rainbow sour candy. And they're the circus peanuts. They came from CVS and they're as stale as a circus peanut can be. And then I bought these watermelon sour jacks because they look so good to me. I might not put them in my sushi. I might just eat these. And then I got some Toll House chips and stuff, just to give it more color when I roll it. And then you ask yourself, Liz, what are you going to use for, well, actually you're asking me, what are you going to use for your sushi rice? Buttercream frosting, of course. What else would I use? Oh sure, there's 1,000 other candies and other sweetie things that I could have done. I could have made tapioca pudding or something. But I don't have all day for this, people. He's coming, and they're coming in about 90 minutes, and this is just a gag, and I'm not going to go out and get special things. Okay, I went out and bought the candy special, but I bought that just off the cuff. I was going through CVS, and I'm like, you know, it'd be fun to make a video with rainbow sour things and circus peanuts. And then I got home, and I'm like, the effed up man is coming for dinner. So I came up with this. They will laugh. And then I really got them peanut butter cup ice cream for dessert because they both love peanut butter cup ice cream, or at least she does. They're great friends. I've been friends with her since college. And she's hilarious. And when life changed on me a few months back, she jumped in, and you just can't believe what this person has done for me. Here comes Mom. She's coming in the back door. So when you hear noise, it's just Mom roaming around in the background. I told her she can't talk. And then, not really, I didn't tell her that. I told her, she said, do you mind? And I said, no. I said, Beth has the television going. Her mom and Bane are talking in the background. You can come back in the house when I'm filming. That's what I said. She laughed. Okay, I'm making buttercream frosting totally without looking at a recipe or really caring. It's just going to be the glue that holds this thing together. So I know that buttercream frosting, some of them have shortening. I'm not getting out the Crisco for this. It's just the glue. So I'm using confectioner sugar, butter, a little bit of milk, and some vanilla. Voila. It'll taste good too, but I gotta make it a lot stiffer if it's gonna be my glue. It can't be oozing out the sushi roll. I might have to. I think I'm gonna go even thicker. I'm gonna make this real thick and then be right back so that you don't have to put up with all of that. Be right back. Hi everybody, I'm back. My buttercream frosting is in the fridge because I thought it would be better if it was as stiff as it could be. And I just realized my camera was trained on that plate. I don't think you even saw me make the frosting. I'm gonna get hater comments like you can't believe the last time I did it. Some girl wrote, she told me off, boy. She told me off a good one. My bum was chapped for a week. Okay, there's the... It says Spangler. Don't they always say Spangler? Oh my God, how great is that? Okay. My friend who's coming for dinner will know why I said that. Okay, look at that. Could that be more beautiful? And they smell like bananas. I'm allergic to bananas. I'm too afraid to even eat one. Why do they why do Circus peanuts not taste like peanut? Why do they taste like bananas? I don't get it. I'm eating some. I haven't had one of those since I was like 10. It was processed in a facility that I love that, but that are used in the production of other products. So pretty much it covers them liability-wise if they say it was made on equipment. And in a facility that makes other products. They're pretty much covered. I know that I'm going to have to shorten these because my strips aren't that wide. They're only that wide. So why don't we do this automatically? I'm not going to make 500 of these. This is just a joke. I'm treating it like it's some sort of amazing culinary masterpiece. Holy cow. I'm julienning Circus peanuts. What on earth? I just want to get ready to roll some of these. I'm not going crazy. Yep, you could use a million other things in this. And if I'd had much more time to plan, I would have bought different things. In fact, I would have bought marshmallows. Because if you jumboed a marshmallow and then you cut a hole in the center and shoved your stuff in, you know, you could make sushi much faster that way, right? But I wasn't prepared. I just bought the silly candy and thought of it afterwards. I'm thinking for color contrast, since there's just so darn much color here, then I'm going to use some of these Toll House chips in there to make it look like there's, I don't know, what's in sushi that's dark colored? Well, the wrapper is. I don't know. Contrast. Pretend it's smoked eel or something. Should I use the watermelon thingies with the rainbow? They'd get kind of lost, wouldn't they? I don't know. I'll open them up just so I'm ready. I'm ready for this whole thing. So great. I gotta eat one of those now. Oh my God. So good. Watermelon flavor. I said I'm sick of artificial flavor. I didn't say fruit flavors. I said potato chip flavors. Those are good and soft. Yummo. Okay. I need another plate. Because I need my board to roll my sushi. I'm hurrying. But where else do you have to be? If you're watching the Olympics, you're not watching me anyway. And if you're not watching the Olympics on a gray Sunday, okay, it's gray where I am, you're not doing anything anyway. You might as well watch me play with candy. Okay, I'm getting the buttercream frosting. You're hanging out in the best place. All those silly people watching the Olympics when they could watch me play with candy. Freaks. Here we go. The build will begin now. Yep, I'm all shadowy today because I had to put the overhead light on. Oh my God, those smell so obnoxious. It's amazing. Look at that. It's going to be like mini sushi. Look how narrow they are. I need smaller fingers. How am I going to do that?
All right. What? I'm pretending to put the rice all out. I don't have a gummy, sour gummy rolling mat, bamboo mat. I'm awfully sorry. This is salmon. Oh wait, you're supposed to put it in the middle, but I don't have a matty thing. So now what do? We need a little more glue, a little more sushi rice. And some chopped up thingy, hoony in there, thingamahooter. I'm gonna pretend this is the mat. Wait, will this work, everybody? I don't know. It's kind of a cute idea, isn't it? Look. It's not perfect, but it's pretty adorable, right? If I come out with these and tell them they're having candy sushi for dessert. Oh my god. It's pretty precious. I'm gonna put some green in there too, so it'll look like cucumber. I'll cut the green off that. Okay, I'm gonna roll up some more of these and then come back and show you my finished plate. Back in a minute. Hi, I'm back. Check that out. I am more happy than a person could be. Look at that! Okay, so I did the sushis. You see them. I did the... What are the rolls called? The regular ones? Is it futomaki? I think so. And then I did the little egg bundles by using the peanuts and wrapping them up. And then I did put some buttercream down to look like sushi rice and did the big lump of salmon and caviar or whatever on top of that. And I think is that nigiri sushi? Somebody correct me. When I used to live in Germany, the menus all said what things were in their real language. But here on my Japanese menu at home, it says raw fish specialties. The only word they use is sashimi. But isn't sashimi just the raw fish part, but not the sitting on top of rice part? Please advise. I have many Asians who watch my videos, and many knowers better than I. I love sushi, but I just don't know what it's all called. And candy sushi? How could that be bad? I love this. I'm going to take 5 million pictures of this so that I can always remember it. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Go back to watching the Olympics now.